back at it again. So if you've been following along, I've been taking absolutely forever, but I've built a 5.0 liter Explorer motor. It was a 98 Mountaineer actually, and I converted it to a 99, everything, all the sensors, the wiring harness, and got it ready because the 99 in 2001 is a drop-in basically for the 98, or really 99, 2000 and up Rangers, sort of, kind of, here and there. But this is supposedly the best swap, is a 2000 with a 99 Explorer motor. So today I'm going to be pulling out the 3.0. Sad to see this piece of crap go, but it runs like all hell, and I've done absolutely everything to it. So I'm thinking it's just got bad rings or bad something or other, bad injectors that I don't feel like getting into. But as far as the parts that I'm going to be swapping over, I mean, everything else kind of hooks up. So heater hoses hook right up to the Ranger. The evap hose is right here and hooks up to the intake right there. Six wire MAF. This bolts up to the Ranger air box, which is great. I have battery cables here, positive, negative. They're just kind of hanging there. I'm gonna have to figure out the high side AC switch, if that's something that I really have to worry about or not. I went ahead and pulled the other side of the starter solenoid wires out of the other Explorer body harness that I have. I pulled them all the way back to the ECU or the other body connectors or whatnot, so I have extra wire just in case. I think I'm gonna de-pin that and then just pin on the other connector that I have, because I have the male and female sides. The AC should all just hook right up. I got new radiator hoses, upper and lower, so it'll hook right up to the radiator that I actually just currently put into that Mountaineer temporarily. It's a Ranger 4.0 dual core radiator. I don't know, 3.0, 4.0 is probably the same on those years, but it's the wider one that fits in this truck. The 5.0 radiator does fit, but the 5.0 radiator, like on this one, this is the one I'm going to put back into the Mountaineer. This one has the provisions for the condenser, which is right here. And the condenser actually is hooked up to the Explorer 5.0 radiator, where the Ranger doesn't have that provision. And then also the Explorer mounting is actually farther back into the firewall than the Ranger one. So I'm going to try and use the one that's the Ranger one currently in the Mountaineer, but it sticks forward slightly more than it needs to. So I may end up getting another Explorer radiator and mounting the condenser to it and then pushing all that forward and creating more space. And if I end up only needing a little bit of space to be able to use this electric fan, I'm gonna go ahead and use that. But if everything seems to fit with the Explorer radiator, then I'll go ahead and just use the regular fan with the fan shroud and everything. But I got this thing working, and that'd be cool to use the electric fan just so I don't have to use this, but I do have it. So yeah, everything was cleaned up, painted. The only things I didn't kind of lock in is, obviously, I didn't put the headers all the way on. This is just a header that I bought on eBay. And this side worked. It's the passenger side. And these things are only like 150 bucks. And then I don't even look at this. I ruined the other side just trying to just do all kinds of stuff to get the middle spark plugs to work, but it's not going to work. So I have the 99 manifolds. Sorry about my clutter, but 99 manifolds there and there. Got them high temp painted. And when I rip out that 3.0, I'm going to go ahead and paint the frame just with some simple Rust-Oleum. And nothing crazy, no pour 15, because mixed reviews. And then after I do the swap, I'm going to end up painting the whole frame and painting all that Explorer suspension that I put on this thing and getting everything ready. I am just going to pull out the 3.0, put in the 5.0, and then I got to do a little bit of work to the transmission. I might just clean it up and toss it on there, but I do want to rebuild it at some point. But I also need to have this thing sort of being able to move around. So I'm going to get it there. But I mean, I've replaced absolutely everything on here. It's even got new EGR hoses, and all the clamps have been sanded and painted, and I've just really touched everything. You know, I wanted to do this one really well because I wasn't sure if I was going to sell this or not. But it's going to retain all the Explorer stuff as far as on the transmission, because it's using the Explorer transmission with all the bells and whistles. I will be using the catalytic converters from the Explorer that bolt right up. It should all fit next to the 470W. They all come around and then mount to the side of the transmission. And from that point on, I'm going to be building the exhaust from there back. So without further ado, let's kind of take where I'm at here and pull this 3.0 and really pull the trigger on this swap. So stay tuned.
Thank you.
That was a lot of garbage. I got the cats off. I got the rest of the exhaust off. The Y pipe I had to get happy with, and I had to cut it to get it out of there, and it was very tight spot. So I had to get creative to knock those guys out. But I got the harness disconnected off of the top of the transmission. I got the crossmember bolts loosened here. I have the two bottom crossmember bolts out of this side and the two crossmember bolts out of this side. I'm gonna leave the top ones in there so when I lower the vehicle, well, actually I may just pull the trans with it up in the air with the trans jack, that doohickey. And then I'll strap up the front of the engine. I mean, strap up the back of the engine so it doesn't fall backwards. And then I'll lower it down and then I'll cherry picker it out. But I got the starter off. I got all the torque converter bolts out through that window. And I'm taking out these front transmission bolts first. And then I'm going to take out the top ones last. If we can see here, there's not very many transmission bolts holding this thing on. There's another one up there. Yeah, I believe another one right there. So I believe there's four more bolts. And this guy is out of here. So, I don't know. I might finish it now. I might finish it after this week. We'll see. But yeah, coming right along. there you have it. 3-0's out, and I didn't even bash anything up. It's pretty impeccable. I only spilled about half the transmission fluid on the ground. And so I'm going to throw the 4-0 mounts on there. I'm going to take off that little spacer right there. And to get to there, you have to take off the shock and spring and the bolts up in there. So I can put on my my DJM lowering springs, 2-inch lowering springs. And I'm going to do a new sway bar and links and just kind of clean up the frame, paint it, and do my best to just get it looking pretty nice before I get that 5-0 lockdown in her. And like I said, this thing was leaking from every hole. It was just a sad state of affairs, you know. So stay tuned. 3-0's out, 5-0 going in. Next episode. Peace.